Hello students, once more welcome to our classes. So today our topic is elementary operation on matrix. Elementary operation on matrix, it is one very important topic for the matrix chapter. So today let us discuss. We have discussed the many properties, but this topic generally the student used to get difficult. Operations, addition we did, multiplication we did, subtraction we did, all operation we did, but this is something different. Transformation operation it is called. So using this transformation we have to find inverse of a square matrix. So let us discuss today the elementary operation on matrix. First, there are six elementary operation, 3 for rows, 3 for columns. There are 6 elementary operation, 3 for rows, 3 for columns. So total 6 elementary operation. So our elementary operation of matrix, there are 6 operations, 3 for rows, 3 for columns. Right? This is 3 for rows, 3 for columns. Right? And what are the operations? First operation, interchange of any two rows or any two columns. The first operation, what it is telling? In the matrix, when we'll apply this operation, if the two rows are there, if you are interchanging, or two columns to be interchanged, just for that is in short, it is written as, in short it is written as Ri interchange with the Rj, or Ci interchange with the Cj. What does it mean? Suppose the matrix is there 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the matrix. Here this is your row 1, this is your row 2. So here R1 interchange with the R2. This is the operation. If you will apply, what will happen? What will happen? This second row becomes first row, first row becomes second row. Means this will be 3, 4 and 1, 2. This is the after operation. This is the first operation is telling. Similarly, can be applied for column. Two rows, two columns can be interchanged. I hope first one is easy. Everybody got? Right. So, this is the first operation. So, that why we have written it is Ri interchange with the Rj or Ci interchange with the Cj. Second one. The multiplication of the elements of any row or column by a non-zero number. This operation is telling ki Ri, suppose Ri is replaced by can be Kri, non-zero number. Zero, it should not be zero. It can be negative, it can be positive, any real number you can apply. And this operation is telling. It can be also applicable to column. Ci replaced by Kci. The ith column can be interchanged with K into Ci. Ith row can be interchanged with the Kri. This is your second operation. Just say for example, one example we are taking. Here it is there. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6 and you are applying R1 by 2R1, then what will happen? The 2 will be multiplied in the R1. So this will be 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6 and it is 4, 5, 6. This will be the matrix after this operation. I hope everybody understood. So here the multiplication of the element of any row or column by any non-zero number. So this is the short symbolically presentation here. This is in the statement way, this is your symbolically way. Next, I hope this example understood. Next, third one. Addition to the element of any row or column, the corresponding elements of any other row or column multiply by any non-zero number. In symbolically, this says that is Ri replaced by Ri plus Krj. It is telling what? Addition to the element of any row. Suppose we are going to the first row. Corresponding element of any, suppose second row you are taking, that is Rj. If any number is multiplied by that and addition you are doing, that is known as your third operation. In same way, it can be applicable to column. Ci replaced by Ci plus Kcj. Kcj. So, this is your third operation. These are the operation, six operation, three for rows, three for columns, right? And we will discuss by that time, note it down. In this elementary operation, the important application is to find inverse of matrix. As I told, we will discuss the properties of elementary operations. The important property here, first how it will be applied, that is in the how to find inverse of the matrix. Let us discuss first what is invertible matrix. Which one will be the invertible? When you say inverse everybody know. Suppose inverse of 5, multiplicative inverse you know, additive inverse you know, multiplicative inverse of 5 is what? 1 by 5 reciprocal you are taking, and additive inverse you are taking, additive inverse 5 is what? Minus 5. So here we will get what you are getting. When you are multiplying that 5 to 1 by 5, you are getting 1. What you have got? That multiplicative inverse in number system you are getting. Similarly, when 5 minus 5, you are getting 0. That is the identity element you are getting. What is your identity matrix? Unit matrix, I to get. So, that will tell our invertible matrix means to how it will do. The definition. What the definition is saying? A is be said to be invertible. Every matrix cannot be invertible. A is invertible if there exist another school matrix B such that AB is equals to BA is equals to identity matrix, and it will satisfy commutative, otherwise it will not happen. AB should be equals to BA is equals to I, then that matrix B is said to be inverse of A. That is the definition of invertible matrix. Let us here, a matrix A, any square matrix A of order M, and another thing, they got two matrix we are multiplying, rectangular matrix, the inverse will not exist. It must be a square matrix. A square matrix, if any A square matrix order M, and if there exist another square matrix B of the same order such that AB is equals to BA is equals to I. Very, very important property this one. This is very, very important. Okay, AB is equals to BA is equals to I. This condition should satisfy. Only AB is equal to I? No. It should be AB is equal to B. We know matrix multiplication is not commutative. But it should be commutative. AB is equal to BA is equal to I. Then B is called inverse of A, and it is denoted by A to the power minus 1. That is A inverse is equal to B. Everybody understood the definition? Few more properties. What are conditions there? As I told, rectangular matrix does not possess inverse matrix. Rectangular in matrix will not have any inverse. Inverse of a square matrix is unique. When you will find inverse of any square matrix, that will be unique. You will not get 2 or 3. No, only 1. And if it exists, condition apply, if it exists. If it will exist, and this is the proof is very very important. You can refer your book, very simple it is. You can refer your book. If inverse of a square matrix is unique, if it exists. Second point, next third point is A and B are invertible matrices of same order, then AB product, AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse. Right, this is another important property. Next, let X, A and B are matrix same order, X one matrix, A, B, they are same order matrices, X is equal to AB. You are writing the equation, X is equal to AB, if it is satisfying, then we can apply these elementary operations. Very, very important point here. If sequence of elementary row operation can be on matrix equation AB, X is equal to AB, then we will apply these row operations simultaneously on X and on first matrix A of AB on RHS. Here, if you are applying row operations, in that case, simultaneously row operation will apply both sides. Left hand side and right hand side. Left hand only X is there. Right hand side AB two matrix is there. When row operation you are doing, then in that case only row you will solve. When if you are solving here, only with row you will go, or only with column you will go. If you are applying row here, then this will be apply on this X. X so it is single matrix. Here two matrix. Means only on the first matrix A, not in the B, row matrix, remember it. For the row matrix, only on the first matrix you will apply, not in the B matrix. If it will be column matrix operation you are doing, then what will happen? Then it will be on X you will apply simultaneously and second matrix B, that I have written. Simultaneously, for the column matrix, column operation, the simultaneously it will be apply column operation on X and second matrix B. This is to be remember, second matrix B of AB on RHS. In RHS, you will apply this on second matrix. I hope everyone by this will apply the to find inverse of a matrix. How to get it? Okay. So, just quickly note it down these properties. Okay, then we will discuss the how to find inverse of a square matrix. To find inverse of a matrix, let A be a square matrix. Then this can be written as A is equal to IA, yes or no? Any square matrix A can be written as I into A of the same order, that property we already known. Here if you are to find A inverse, express this is equation, express equation 1 in the form I is equal to BA, I is equal to BA, this is using row operations. And if you want to apply column operations, then you need to take A is equal to AI. A is equal to AI and you will express it I is equal to AB. It is using column operations. very, very important. If suppose, as we told, the equation will be simultaneously solved, operation will apply either only rows or only columns. We can't mix here. Here, when this equation, either this is A is equal to IA or this is A is equal to AI, meaning is same. For row operation, you will consider A is equal to IA. And for column operation, you will consider A is equal to AI. For row operation, you will express by using this elementary operation, I is equals to BA. This B will be your A inverse. And in this case, if the column operation you are applying, then you will apply I is equals to AB. Then this B will be your A inverse. Understood? This is the way to find A inverse. So, I hope here that is A inverse is nothing your B. Any one of the operation you have to apply. One example, let us find, and one note you remember. Note you remember. The note is, suppose you are solving this A is equal to IA or A is equal to AI. By solving this, if you are come across any row or column are all element are any row or columns, all element are zero. Any row or any columns, all element if it will be zero, then A inverse does not exist. Right? That is to be remembered. Any row, any column by the during this operation, when you are simplifying, when you are bringing in this form, I is equal to, when you are bringing in this form, I is equal to, when solving this one and you are getting any row or any column, all element are zero, then in that case A inverse does not exist. Here one example let us solve. First let us solve for a 2 by 2 order matrix. Example, find A inverse if A is equals to, the elements are here 1, 2, 2, minus 1. 1, 2, 2, minus 1. This is one example here. Let us solve. You have to find A inverse. Here, suppose by row operation we have to do. Okay, using row operation. Here we will solve using row operation. Right, let for row operation how will I write, let A is equals to, what will write, IA. Here look at it, for row operation if we are going to apply, A is equal to AI will write, A IA will write, and in this case that is A value write down, that is 1 2 2 minus 1, and this I is identity matrix, second order matrix, identity matrix. What it will be? 1, 0, 0, 1. And this will be, because as already you have written, when you are applying in the previous note, you have written, when you are solving the equation by using row operation, the operation will be simultaneously, will be applicable on the first and here in the LHS, as well as the first matrix of the second. So here this will be no use, only A should be written, no need to write anything, no value to write, only A you write down. Now here to express, what is our aim? Our aim is to express, it is I is equal to BA. I is equal to BA means these two operation will be applied, this one will make as identity matrix and this is one will be your, that will be B matrix. what is the you will apply, how will you do. So here the rule I am telling, suppose this is your steps are, the first step you will go, this is one step, one you will make it is identity matrix one. Second step you will go for it is zero. Third step you will make this is as one, third step, and fourth step you will go for here zero. These are the steps. Step. First step one. Second step zero. Third step one. Mane this rule is how will go? The rule you will go this method. This is the U method. This way. And you are starting from here, here, where here, where here. This way you will travel. You are starting from here, ending at here. This is the rule. Now, what we have to apply? Elementary operations. Here already the first element is 1. So no need to do. Next we have to make this is 0. How we can make it 0? As we have studied the operations, what are the which operation is applicable? If we will multiply 2 here and subtract it, then it will be 0. Means if suppose how will do your last row 2, second row element will change, R2 will be replaced by R2 minus 2R1. Here K is equal to minus 2, Ri replaced by KRJ. This is R2 replaced by R2 minus 2R1. And what are you getting? And there will be what you are getting, you write down. We will get, this is implies the first one as it is no changes. Here also first row you can write as it is, and since it is no changes, to avoid confusion you can write down. Now this is 0. Now this element R2 minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, 2 are 4, minus 5. Here it is 0 minus, it is 5. Because simultaneously all element it will be applied. 0 minus 2, and this will be 1 minus 2 into 0, it is same 1 will be there. Now what you have got? This is the first one, your 1, 0 you have got. Next step what will go, you have to make it, it is a 1. How you can make it 1? This can be done if you are multiplying by minus 5. 1 by 5, minus 1 by 5, this becomes 1, yes or no? Because minus 5 reciprocal, how will get 1? So this can be written as R2 replaced by R2 by minus 5, or R2, otherwise you can write R2 into minus 1 by 5. Then what are you, minus 1 by 5 you multiply, this is first row as it is 1 2, it is a 0, this will be 1, and here it will be first row as it is 1 0, minus 2, minus 1 by 5, it is 2 by 5, and this will be minus 1 by 5. Now you have got 1 here, and this A as it is. Next you have here, you have got which step? 1 0 1 you have got, 1 0 1 got. This one you want to make it 0, fourth step, last step. So how to get? Same way here, apply R1 replaced by R1 minus 2R2, because 2 into 1, 2, 2 minus 2, 0. So what are you getting here? Here your first 1 minus, that will be 1 will be there. This is 2 minus 2, it is 0. Here 0, here 1, because the second row no changes here. So this will be 1 minus 4 by 5, 1 minus 2 into 2 by 5, how much? It is 4 by 5. 1 minus 4 by 5 is how much? 1 by 5. Yes or no? Now, next, it is the second element is 0. 0 minus of 2 into minus 1 by 5, minus minus plus means it is 2 by 5. And this will be your, again this is second as it is 2 by 5 and this is minus 1 by 5 and this is your A. Now, what you have got? It is in which form? Now, it is in the form I is equals to BA. So, your A inverse is equal to B, that is your A inverse is equals to 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 2 by 5, minus 1 by 5. Got it? This is your required A inverse. Understood? Same way, you can go for the third order matrix. For third order, we can go for the steps 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In this way, what will make? You will make, this is 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 1, 0, 0, 0. So, if we go see the graph will be, the flow chart will be going this way. This is this way, where this way, where this way, okay. And this is starting from here. This is in this way you will go, okay. You will reach here. So, this is the way for the third one working rule. Working rule. I hope everybody understood this elementary operation, okay. So, in this way you have to find inverse of a matrix using elementary operation, okay student. So, I hope you understood this topic. So, you must like this video and subscribe it to get more number of videos. Thank you students.